All right. Locked up. You got your phone.
All right, let's go. Yep. I'll keep climber in the morning. Hey.
What's up? Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Dang, it's happening.
No, I was gonna say nothing could be finer than having a partner like Jordan to climb on camp.
Oh, thank you.
Let's go rock climbing! They should be happier than that.
Jordan may have targeted Mark. It's very sad, actually. He's preying on a senior citizen. Poor, short, old man, so that he can go and send his projects.
Mark's this kind of old school crusher guy, and he's making some resurgence at age 63, which is pretty cool.
Mark on-sighted Moonlight Buttress.
Oh wow, I didn't think Mark could do that.
Mark Hudon did Moonlight. Jordan did Moonlight too, but yeah, he's 25. Oh, yeah, he's supposed to do it. It's supposed to be easy for him.
Mark's goal is to free climb the free rider. Period. However long that takes.
You ready?
Yep.
All right, let's have fun.
All right.
Be great, okay?
Be safe.
My goal is to not have any fun and to free climb it in a day. And just suffer.
And then do you know anything about Jordan?
I just know that Jordan's like a young crusher guy.
Jordan Campbell, right? What the fuck's his last name? Cannon.
Sure, I'm looking good, you know?
Well, for one thing, Jordan stole my look. Well, dude, get some different glasses, man. Not original.
Yeah, I first heard about Jordan because he was doing big link-ups in the Sierra. And I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. You don't meet that many young guys that are out adventuring like that.
Right when he started, he had a mission. The first time I met him, I'm like, hey, man, I'm looking to go do Moonlight Buttress in Zion. Do you want to do it? And he was just like, yeah, let's do it. And like literally a day later, he drove up and we did Moonlight the next day.
And in a lot of ways, Jordan is an up-and-comer. You know, he's still getting better.
He is incredibly passionate about climbing, and he takes it very seriously, to the point where he's super nerdy about it.
I love the movement of climbing and challenging myself on hard things, but it's the history and the tradition and the mentality from the past that inspires me to go outside and have these adventures of my own.
He cares about climbing history in a way that I find sort of refreshing. Though it might be to his detriment a little bit too, because if he didn't care about climbing history and just trained in the gym all the time, he'd probably be a stronger climber.
One summer, I was on my way to Donner Summit to go to a climbing event. Mark Hudon happened to be there, and I had always wanted to meet him. I was very aware of the climbing he did in the 70s. I thought it was like the coolest thing ever, and he was like the man, because he started a movement of free climbing on El Cap 40 years ago.
In climbing, we've always had these dark horses, right? These people who aren't the famous people, not the Honnolds and Tommies, but out there climbing at the same level.
People don't really know about Max and Mark unless they're like deep Yosemite nerds, which I am.
Mark Hudon and Max Jones, they did so many hard second ascents or sort of obscure first ascents that I'm sure at the time were completely badass, but then after 25 years of history, you're sort of like, oh, who is that guy?
But back then, a route that had a couple pitches of 511 on it was considered one of the hardest routes in the world. So Astroman, at the time, that had five pitches of 511 was just considered crazy difficult.
Astroman was the standard hard man route in the 70s, which they did the second ascent of.
We remember the first ascensionists because they're all stone masters, they're big heroic figures. But nobody ever knows about the second ascensionists, who are obviously just as good at climbers.
Astroman was free climbed by like the icons of the valley. You know, it was Long, Backer, and Kalk.
The second ascent is often in better style and actually done by better climbers.
I mean, they were just as good as those guys. They just weren't in the limelight as much.
So Mark did the second ascent of Astroman and then went on to do the second ascent of the Phoenix, which is maybe more proud just because it's a lot harder.
The Phoenix was the first 513 in the world.
And he did it without the use of friends or camps.
They did it in the style that was expected in Yosemite. They didn't rehearse it. They didn't top rope it. They didn't hang on it.
The fact that Mark did the second ascent of the Phoenix is an example of what a cutting edge climber he was for his time.
As we did more free climbing, we started talking about it. It's like, hey, what do you think about free climbing potential on the South, eh?
Mark and Max came up with this idea of free as can be, to ascend the wall using only their hands and feet as much as they possibly could.
Things were starting to get free climbed around the valley, but it wasn't really getting applied to the big walls yet. And they were like, why don't we take this free climbing that we're learning on the surrounding crags and apply that to El Capitan?
They didn't allow themselves to get bogged down, thinking that it wouldn't be worth it unless the entire route would go free.
There's lots of cool pitches that would be the coolest thing ever to go free climb.
We pour over the topo and pour over the gear list. Okay, that might be hard. That might go free. That might not go free. And then we went, cool, let's just go up there.
He basically freed all the hard climbing on Freerider.
You know, like, wow, we just did a brand new 510 pitch. This is so neat. I can't believe anyone hasn't done this already. You know, it's got such great moves up there. And then, oh, this next pitch goes 8, 5, 7, 8, 2. Bam, 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 bam. We knock it off and it's 510D. You know, we're going, wow, this is neat. So we just kept going and going and going.
They became the first climbers to free climb the Enduro Corner, which ended up being the first 512 on El Cap.
Climbing 512, almost 3,000 feet off the ground, was harder than 99% of the people were climbing in the valley at the time anyway.
When they summited, they had freed all but 300 feet of El Cap.
But it was just the fun. I mean, we wanted to go there and have fun. We wanted to go there and see what you could do.
Before I met Mark at Donner Summit, I had known that he had put in a few attempts on the free rider, but, you know, fell short for whatever reason. And so that was what I was really eager to talk to him about, see if he had plans to go back and if he had been training and when he was gonna try and make it happen.
In the very back?
In the very back. Because now you've got that total wrong calc look where it dangles down. And we got a rack of the original Friends. That was it. That was the most modern rack of cams known to man. I tried to get on Freerider with various partners. Didn't really do too well.
When I brought it up to him, it was like, yeah, no, I kind of like wrote it off. Hasn't been on my mind. Haven't been climbing that much. Well, I'd need a partner. I'd need somebody to do a lot of climbing with. I'd need somebody to haul it. Like, it's a big thing. And I was like, I can be that person.
And I told Jordan, I said, to do it, I need to dedicate a year of my life.
That'd be so fun to climb with Mark for a year and help him try and do the free rider.
Him offering to support me and me realizing that time is running out in my life and me wanting to do it, I just said, okay, I'm gonna devote a year of my life.
All right, now it's official. We're like making it happen. Good, Mark. Find that right foot. Okay, relax here. Relax. Nicely done.
Beautiful moon.
Mark just sent the roof, first try. Which doesn't seem like a big deal, but for Mark at this point in his life on this route, it kind of is. Off to a good start here. So far, the ideal experience that we've been looking for, but we're at the very start, so. I have a good feeling about everything, though.
Back in the day, we used to climb up the front and hike down the back, but now modern climbers hike up the back and wrap down the front.
Like I said, modern climbers do more rappelling than climbing these days.
Did you have to take a carriage to the base?
They used to brush the holds with dinosaur bone.
I don't.
Modern dinosaur climbing El Cap.
All right. See ya.
The free rider is one route, but it's 3,200 feet of rock climbing. And in one specific spot, the hardest spot, there's actually two ways to get through there. One is known as the boulder problem. The other is known as the Teflon corner. Jordan is choosing to do the boulder problem, while Mark is choosing to do the Teflon corner.
Ow, fuck. Ow!
What was that?
Oh, that beaner pinched my bicep. Fuck.
The Teflon corner is slippery. It's more slippery than Teflon. It's slick as snot.
It is essentially a 90-degree corner that is like glass on both sides. In order to ascend it, he has to press with his hands and feet and just sort of levitate up without slipping off.
It is just disproportionately harder and less pleasant than the rest of the route. Yeah, I wish him luck, honestly, fuck.
Once I get the Teflon, then I know I can do the route. It's like that's just gonna be a giant relief.
Oh yeah, holds all over the place up here.
Chalk builds trust in non-existent holds.
So the main thing Mark has to do to prepare for the freerider is climb a lot and overcome the idea that 512 is this big hard number in his mind, particularly 512D, you know, the rating of the Teflon corner.
I didn't exactly know how he was gonna do it, how he was gonna support me, but when I showed up in Joshua Tree in March, he had a total plan. He had, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do that, we're gonna do this, we're gonna go here, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do this. And I was just going, damn.
Mark, how's this pitch going?
It's hard.
In the past year, Mark and Jordan have been on a road trip together all over the US. Training and preparing for these two goals.
I feel like a hammerhead shark.
Jordan is not a chill rock climber.
Yeah, money. Come on, crank.
He likes to lay everything out. He's very organized.
Nobody else, I can imagine, would have taken the time to teach him the new ways of climbing, of getting fit, of rappelling down and working El Cap from above.
How was that for you?
That was, well, I'm alive.
Okay, today we're teaching an old dog new tricks.
Me being the old dog.
You only look old.
Well, okay, thanks.
They've been shredding all over the place. They've been in Vegas, they've been in Zion, they've been in the Valley, all these iconic big wall areas and sending hard routes.
The lighting's making you look way more ripped right now than you actually are.
Hey, fuck you.
It's hard even to just to talk about all the routes we've done. And these routes, these routes are hard. I mean, there's days where I just think I'm gonna die. But yet, I just seem to be coming back stronger.
Yes!
It was tough, but I've just basically had the best climbing year of my life.
That's the best I've ever done.
I knew you could do it.
That was cool.
Perfect.
I felt casual.
Jordan's very exact about his plan. I want to get a free rider and I want to do it, but if I don't have fun doing it, it's almost going to be not as good. You know, fun, and I keep saying this, fun is job one. We started doing more, you know, fun stuff. I mean, with a more of a fun attitude.
Well, I had just never prioritized fun as job one.
Is that right? Where else are you gonna find a cash-only business that's this much fun? Unless we're talking massage parlors and
Here we are at the base of the Teflon.
Nothing could be sweeter than being up on El Cap with my buddy Jordan in the morning.
These guys keep peeing on us. It's called a golden shower. Not as glorious as it sounds.
I'm psyched. I'm trying not to put any pressure on myself. I've probably done a couple thousand perfect moves so far.
How you feeling?
I don't feel okay.
Just get up at once.
Yeah.
It's hard for a lot of people to comprehend how hard it is to free climb El Cap. And it's even harder to do at an older age like Mark is.
Being an old guy, that weighs on me. I mean, it takes me longer to recover, and when I give it some effort, I give it some effort because I've got like 5 or 6 tries in me, and then I am done. Good. You know, I'm completely spent.
This is not gonna be good.
With what?
Oh, my hand.
Your palm?
You know, I got that blister last time. It's already starting to leak right now.
Is it?
Yeah.
I'm gonna put on a little crack glove, put it on backwards.
Nothing could be finer than being a Teflon climber.
Good.
Well, that seems just utterly impossible.
It's crazy. It's literally just 15 feet away from success.
I don't know.
Getting a little too warm.
Yeah, it's getting pretty hot.
Why don't you come down for a sec?
I'm just not seeing a path. It's just, everything's just so hit or miss. I'll certainly go up there tomorrow morning, but I'm gonna have to feel a lot better than I do now.
Is this your new thing, the boxer warm-up?
Yep, boxer warm-up. I'm getting ready to fight.
Death. It's been a while since we've done this. I feel like I got nothing on me.
Well, it's because I'm carrying it. Oh, I forgot my chalk bag. I don't need my chalk bag. Let's go climbing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on, let's go climbing with me. Come on, let's go climbing with me. El Cap, free rider in a day.
With Mark.
With Jordan. This is gonna be so cool.
The holy grail of big wall free climbing is to free climb El Cap in a day.
Good, how are you?
Throughout history, probably only a handful of people have done it.
Yeah.
Ovvio che farlo in libera è un palo nel culo.
Dai che finisce tutto nel film dell'Arterix, vecchio.
Ah?
L'audio finisce nel film dell'Arterix.
Secondo me lo possono togliere.
Ma porca troia, questa è una merda.
Mark, line's fixed!
Okay, thank you! Really? Puoi calare anche sulla corda.
Restart.
What's that?
Restart.
Yeah.
The sun was right there, was marching towards us. He didn't really have enough time to relax and calmly go back up there.
It was hot already, and my skin was feeling bad. And so I knew that if I had to do it in the sun, it could like cost the whole ascent. So I really needed to make this moment count and do it this next try, or like that was it.
Oh boy, that felt really high pressure.
That was fun.
Good work.
Oh boy.
Good work.
Thanks.
Good work.
I was really glad to not have to do that in the sun. And...
yeah.
That was wild.
Gotta improve that flexibility.
Warm those legs up.
All right.
Whatever it takes.
Let's go. One more time.
See how, I mean, the arete gets way better?
Yeah.
You can lay back up the arete until you get that black knob and then fucking come back into the black knob like a hero. Pull in.
What are you trying up here, Mark?
Well, I don't know. I'm just sort of wasting time, actually. Come around the corner, get up on this, get to this hand. And then now the corner that you're pressing against on the other side is actually good for lie backing. I've got a little dime edge here. If I could stand here, I might be able to reach there. And then maybe swing over.
Look at you being all futuristic.
You know, I just don't want to, waste too much time here. I don't want to waste too much strength. I'm just, you know, this is sort of
good. You know, everyone's always saying, oh, just keep working on it. It'll fall together. You'll finally see how it's working, and then, bam, one of these times you'll just do it. Every single move was so powerful and so tenuous and, to me, so unrepeatable. It just wasn't working. Well, I just couldn't do it. So I just grabbed the first bolt, ate it up on that, grabbed the second bolt, ate it up on that, and free climbed off that. So given that I free climbed the rest, I'm gonna be able to say that I free climbed El Cap with 2 8 moves. Yeah, you know, like on my tombstone, there won't be a tombstone because I'm gonna get cremated. But if it says as free as can be, that'll be all right. That'll be good. As free as can be. And he had a lot of fun. That's what I want.
Well, I was just saying that I was imagining an 18-year-old Mark Hudon sitting right there.
Yeah.
45 years ago. It's a classic photo.
It's totally freaking nuts.
Freaking sitting there on your haul bag.
No. I mean, it's the most amazing thing that I could be back here. You know, all that time after having been here on my first ascent and been here with Max, and it's just an amazing thing.
I'm still proud of you, like I said.
I know, Jordan, you're gonna have to come back here in 39 years.
I know, I should.
You'll be 65.
I'll only have to come back just to see what it was like for you.
Oh boy. Made it. Great job.
Oh God. You did great. Oh God. Oh shit. That was freaking nuts.
Oh. How long have we been talking about doing that?
More than a year.
Are you happy? Happy with that?
Yeah. I'm gonna take that.
Two moves, that's it.
Two moves of aid.
You did all the rest.
Yeah, I did all the rest. I free climbed the whole thing.
Yeah, you did. Man, it's freaking wild, isn't it?
Oh, shit.
Back in my day, El Cap felt like it was 15,000 feet tall. El Cap hadn't been free climbed. We never would have imagined that it would be free climbed in a day. And now I have a really good friend who can actually go do it. So he and I, we're like the past and we're the future. And we're sort of like, I mean, I'm sort of handing that off, I guess. I mean, I'm just totally proud of him. You know, he's such a good guy. I mean, he's got physical talent. He's a great rock climber. I love watching him rock climb. He's honest and he's open and he's friendly and he's helpful. And anything I can possibly do to help him, I'll do it.
Mark deserves an award for that as well. That's not an easy route to jug.
Jordan free climbing freerider in a day, it can't help but solidify a lot of confidence in himself.
Oh. Off the way.
Holy moly, off the way. Oh, Jesus.
Oh good job, good job. Thanks
good
a lot.
Job.
Thanks
that
so
was
much.
Awesome. Oh, boy.
Oh. Until I turn to starfish for once.
Jordan doesn't need to be spending time climbing with me. He could go be doing stuff far, far, far more difficult than I could ever do. I mean, it's the greatest gift anyone's ever given me. You know, it's crazy.
Shall we do a summit selfie?
The coolest thing about climbing is you get to meet and hang out with your heroes. And like, Mark's a real life hero in my mind.
When you look back at the day that we first met, I mean, neither of us ever would have imagined that our partnership and our friendship would develop the way that it has. You know, it just like happened that way. And so I'm super grateful that it has become what it has.
I mean, it's really been funny because I go, damn, I'm going to know this guy for the rest of my life. You know, however long that is.
Nothing could be finer than being an El Cap climber in the morning.
Except it's afternoon.
Felt the sunshine through my cold window pane. I never knew the robins sing like zip-a-doo-doo. I've never danced through puddles in a blue apron rain. But now I do it all thanks to you. And when the cold winter winds start blowing town, I'll never feel cold again as long as you're around. I've never heard the bells chime like a ring-a-ding-ding, but now it's all springtime, all thanks to you.